Hi, and welcome to the Boolean crowd. Tonight, we're joined by the main man, Mr. George Boole himself. Can we get a big round of applause, please?
Hi, it's great to be here.
To start the night off, could you tell us a small bit about your early life? Because from the sounds of it, it wasn't easy.
Well, I was born in Lincolnshire in 1779. I was self-taught in foreign languages and took up a junior teaching position in Doncaster Highman School. To bring in money from my family, at the age of 19, I opened my own school in Lincoln. I then took over at Waddington outside Lincoln, and later I took over a boarding school in Lincoln. I became a prominent local figure, and I set up a building society in 1847.
That's all very impressive. And now, could you tell us about the work that made you so famous in Ireland? The work that you did at UCC?
I was contacted by UCC in 1849 and became the first professor of mathematics at what was known as Queen's College, now UCC. I met my future wife, Miss Mary Everest, in 1850. We married a few years later.
And could you please tell us a small bit about the work that made you the prominent figure that you are today in mathematics, your Boolean logic?
I have a short presentation prepared for this question, actually.
That's great to hear. Could we have that rolled, please?
Hello and greetings. My name is George Boole. I am a philosopher and mathematician from the 19th century. So what, you ask? Well, thanks to my work in logic and groups of data, you are able to sort through electronic databases in a quick and efficient manner. There are three Boolean operators of which you should be aware. The OR operator, the AND operator, and the NOT operator. Let's say I'm doing a research paper on robotics. I can search for the terms that essentially mean the same thing, at least to me. So, I can search for robots or androids. The search engine will look for records that contain either of these terms. Using the OR operator will expand the scope of my search and give me more results. If I want to search for items which contain at least two different concepts, I want to use the AND operator. Here, we search for robotics and ethics. Have you ever done a search and got 10,000 results? Using the AND operator will narrow down the scope of my search and give me fewer results. The NOT operator lets me look for records that contain one term, but not another. For example, Android. NOT. Operating system. This will bring up records dealing with Androids, but exclude any records that include operating systems. I must be very careful when using the NOT operator. It is very easy to inadvertently eliminate records that might be very helpful to my research. So, there you have it. The OR operator. The AND operator. And the NOT operator. Happy researching, everybody.
And finally, I know it'll be emotional, but could you tell us a small bit about your death, because I'm sure it would interest the listeners.
One day in 1864, I walked 2 miles in the pouring rain and then had to lecture in my soaking clothes. I soon became very ill with a bad cold and high fever. My wife decided that she should treat me with the cause of my illness, so she sent me to bed and poured buckets of water over me. Shockingly, my illness got worse, and on the 8th of December, I died of a fever-induced pleural effusion.
Thank you very much for your time, Mr. Boole.
Thank you very much.